And welcome back to Embracing Your Virtue. So today's topic, we're going to be exploring the question, why is it so hard for moms to ask for help? And to join me in this conversation is a very, very dear friend of mine, Zulay Mclean. Zulay is a wife, she's a mother of two beautiful girls, and she's also a high school special education teacher. Zulay is also a leader in her church, and she is an amazing, I mean, amazing cook. So I'm so excited to have her on the show today. Zulay, welcome.
Thank you, Samantha. Thank you for having me. This is really exciting. It's exciting and humbling and a lot of a hodgepodge of emotions. But thank you for having me.
I'm so glad to have you. Okay, so why don't we start with just a word of prayer?
Sure. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Okay.
God, I just thank you for this opportunity to come together as sisters in Christ to talk and to share. God, we just pray that you would be in our midst today. We pray that you would lead and guide our discussion, that you would influence the things that we say and share today. And we just ask, oh God, that this would be for your glory and for the souls of men. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. So I'm going to just forewarn you and your viewers in advance. Because real life happens, you might hear some real life in the background. And so I apologize in advance between everything. I mean, my house isn't chaotic right now, but there's a toddler. And, you know, as you well know, you can't control when they say and do things. So,
yes, no, it's totally fine. I think, you know, the motto of my show is honesty and reality. And this is the reality of mom. So,
yeah.
It's all good. I happen to look out when my kids are at T-ball right now, but you know, we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
Totally fine. Cool. So we always have such good conversations. So I thought, I'm like, let's talk about this. You and I are both busy moms, right? In different ways. Stay-at-home mom with three young kids. You know, your kids are a toddler, teenager, but you also have a full-time job, church ministry, and everything else in between, family, et cetera, right? So I wanted to explore this topic of asking for help. I read an article that said the hardest part of motherhood is asking for help and taking it. And I thought that was really interesting because I'm like, you would think the hardest part of motherhood is like labor, it's the, you know, actually rearing the children. But this person said asking for help. So why do you think that's so hard for moms to do?
Because we have been miseducated and conditioned to think that we can do it all. It's hard, right? So God has been teaching me that I am an amalgamation, right? A living and walking container almost of experiences and things that have spoken into my life and things that I've observed over the years, right? Mm-hmm. And that comes from many different areas or dynamics. My culture, mm-hmm. The media, people that I've seen throughout my life in work and in just regular life, right? And there's things that give positive impressions, right? Or have positive impressions on you. You're like, I want to do that. That looks really cool, right? I want to be like that. That looks really cool, right? And then there's other things that just kind of plant seeds into us that make us believe that this is what you should look like given the role that you have, right? So as a mother, you should always have an exceptional, spectacular meal for your family. As a wife, you should always be the embodiment of virtuosity and perfection and meekness and all of these things. As a mother, you should always be available for everything that your children need and all of these things, right? And with these images that we've seen throughout our lives, it's like, I have to be that. I think that there's seldom an example of I got here because people helped me get here. Mm-hmm. So we don't identify with it, right? And I think that even as I was saying that, the only images that you see of like help are for women who are in a position where they can afford that. But that's not the reality for most of us, you know? Mm-hmm. And then there's pride, right? There's also, I did all of this. Mm-hmm. You know, my house is clean, my kids look good, my husband's happy, you know, I'm performing well at work. Like, all of that feeds into our pride. And it's like, and if you ask for help, then you didn't do it all. And, you know, can you brag as much on the inside, even if you don't brag, can you still feel as good knowing that you didn't do it from beginning to end yourself?
Right. Yeah. Wow. I think you touched on so much. I think, like, to the last thing you said, it's that performance culture that we live in, right?
Yes.
It's like where our value becomes tied to what we produce, right? And to the, yep, what we accomplish.
Yes.
Right? And so it's like, if we're not producing, if we're not accomplishing and getting it all done, then it's like, I know I've experienced that where it begins to challenge my self-worth a little bit, you know,
yes,
and that's something that, like, I have to allow God to rid out, you know, like, no, who I am, my value is not determined by how well I produce all these things, you know, whether it's work, family, etc.
Yeah, and might I add that performance culture that we've been reared in is completely contradictory to the message of the cross.
Absolutely.
Right? Mm-hmm. So, like, we cannot earn our salvation. And I don't mean to be hyper spiritual. I'm not like Susie Christian, who's like, I've arrived, you know? It's essentially God has given us salvation through Jesus, right? And it's just accepting what he has given to us that allows us to inherit that salvation. It's not anything that we can actually do. Like, we can't have this list of things that we accomplish and it's like, okay, I'm good now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Likewise, we have an expectation, especially as women, to be able to do it all so that we can look good and earn this. But it's like, mm-hmm, but God isn't calling us to that, right? Like, mm-hmm, I think, I don't know, a couple of years ago, maybe 2-3, I don't know, at some point fairly recently, I was reading Proverbs 31, and, you know, it's like the Christian woman's anthem.
Yep.
Right? It's like, this is what you should aspire to. Mm-hmm. First of all, it starts off with, like, kind of hinting at this image of a woman is really hard to find. But yet, mm-hmm, still, we still aspire to it. But there's a verse, I wish I had my Bible right next to me, I should have, but there's a verse, where it talks about her providing for her servants, for her maids. And it was like, Lord, she had help.
Hello, yes.
The Proverbs 31 woman had help.
Yes.
She had help.
Yeah.
She had help. Okay.
Exactly. Yes. It's verse 15. I know it by heart. Okay.
Oh, there. There you go. She had help.
Yes.
But we don't know how to do that.
Exactly, so, exactly. With all that, and she had help, and look how much still she had to do, right? Like, you, so imagine
before technology existed in this form, right? Like, you couldn't just, like, order a cleaning service, or there was no machine to wash your clothes.
Right. There was no Amazon subscription to shop for you. Exactly.
No. She had help. She had help.
Yeah, when I'm like, man, when I realized that, it was like, you know, I was like, yes.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. So I want to circle back to another thing you talked about, like the influence of culture on, like, the expectations that we place on ourselves as mothers and as wives.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm curious, like, with your Dominican American background, like, how do you see that played out in, you know, some of the ways in which you've parented, and, like, what has God kind of taught you, you know, in the midst of that?
Okay, I am going to try to truncate this because he has shown me a lot as it relates to my culture, and you don't need a 45-minute video. culture has been a ginormous influencer over my life. Now, culturally, I have been taught to do things like, what's the word? From scratch, right? So don't take shortcuts, you know, sit there and scrub everything, you know, do everything yourself. And my culture is very matriarchal, right? So I grew up with very strong-minded women, and they showed that they just did everything. My grandmother literally made everything from scratch. To this day, she will not eat. I mean, she'll eat certain kinds of processed foods, but when she eats during the day, it has to be from scratch, right? Like, that's just what it is. So cleaning, taking care of your house, everything is like, it's a woman's job. It is a woman's role to do this. Don't get me wrong. I enjoy taking care of my home. But culturally, what's been ingrained in me is that this is my job and no one else's. And I think also, while culturally we've accepted help in different ways, like with things coming into the home, it's always like, it's just your job to take care of the home. And it's also a sense of pride. And it's also, no one else can do it like you can. And there's so many layers to it, you know, financial accessibility, right? The only women, for me culturally, and what I saw, the only women who had someone else come in and take care of the home were women who were rich and could afford a maid or some kind of a servant or something like that, right? And it's like, if you're not rich, you don't do that. You don't associate yourself with that.
Yeah.
And even so, like for me, I'm a first generation born Dominican American, right? I always just say I'm Dominican, but I'm first generation, right? So this may sound weird, but it's kind of like, although educationally and financially, I've been able to do more than my mom and other women like her, not because I'm better, but just because I had the opportunity. Like, she pushed me so hard that it was like, this is where I'm going, and I'm grateful for it. Bringing someone into my home to like clean it and do stuff like that, it's almost like subconsciously, I'm conflicted about, you know, am I at a higher place that I bring someone that socioeconomically is not where I am, right? Mm-hmm. And so culturally, I'll say this, I've never had a conversation like that, but there's always been the implication.
Right?
Yeah. Like, it's kind of like, well, who do you think you are if you have someone coming in to clean your house? I'm thinking of it in Spanish and it, you know, it won't make sense, but it's like, who do you think you are? Mm-hmm. Having someone else come in, do you think that you're at that place? So that's like a big thing. That's a big thing, yeah, culturally. I hope that makes sense. It was a lot, but.
No, it does. And I can totally relate. I mean, even as African Americans, for centuries, we were the help, you know? And so it's like, to get help, it does feel weird. It feels like,
yeah,
you know, I remember this was before the kids and we had a little bit more money. and we were both working, but I remember like Leon took our laundry and like did like a drop-off service. Mm-hmm. So they like washed it and folded it and everything. Let me tell you something. I felt like the Jeffersons. I was like, oh, we live in large and in charge. Like, you know.
Only ever done that, I think, like once. And it was out of desperation. And even that felt weird. I know. We're so conditioned.
Yeah, but it was like, I'm going to say, it wasn't until, you know, kid number two came into the picture that I really, you know, I'm like, they're so close in age.
Right.
That I was like, okay, I need... help might be something that's worth investing in. Mm-hmm. Because it's like, okay, you're trying to recover from childbirth, you know, take care of a toddler, nursing a baby, etc. You know, but even then, the conversations with Leon, it was hard for him to embrace the idea of paying for a nanny or a babysitter or a cleaning service. Because as another. Yeah.
You know, why am I paying someone to do something for me that I know how to do?
Right. And it's like, especially too, he's African American as well. So it's all these examples of strong Black women who are persevering, right? And so you know, even looking at like, what is our image of what a strong woman is? It's a woman that like, that still does it in the midst of the adversity. But, you know, we don't ever really, I don't know if we've ever really taken a look at our moms who kind of did it all and thought about, well, they did it all, but yeah, at what cost? You know, they're exhausted. How's their emotional health? Are they, you know, are they being snappy and short with the rest of the family because they're just overworked?
Right.
Yeah. So it's like, yeah, we, yeah, technically we might be able to do it all, but at what cost? You know, cost to quality time. Yeah.
I think that like God has shown me, like, even if we think that we are doing it all or can have it all, it is a false reality. Mm-hmm. There's some area where it's not covered.
Yeah.
But we've been convinced that we can, and it's like, it's okay. It really is more than fine to just say, I'm going to take care of my kids. I'm going to take care of my home, or I'm going to have a full-time job and still have children at home and not beat myself up that my house doesn't look like a Pinterest post. Like, we're living real life.
Zulay, this discussion is great, and we're just getting started. So why don't we stop here, and we'll come back for a part two. In about 2 weeks, we'll show part two, and we'll continue this discussion. Is that good?
Awesome. Yeah, let's do that. Yep.
Great, guys. Stay tuned. Make sure that you are subscribing so that you are aware of videos that are coming up as they hit. Please follow us on Instagram and Facebook, and we'll see you soon. Bye.